Hi, this is Jeffrey Rhoades from experimentalhomesteader.com. And before I begin, I wanted to say we did receive this item for free or at a reduced price for honest opinions. All opinions are our own. And what I have here is Leader Accessories Super Mag Hauler Steel Hunting Game Deer Cart. This does have a 550-pound capacity. And what I'm going to try to do here is show you how to assemble this. Now, this is their instruction sheet. One side of it provides the list of items that come with it. And the other side is actually the instructions showing you how to assemble this. Okay. One thing that it does mention that I, had to find, it does not come with a large wrench for attaching the bolts of the, or the nuts on the axle. So you have to come up with your own large wrench, because it does come with some small wrenches for the smaller nuts. But the big nuts that you use with the axle and attaching the wheels, they do not provide, so you have to come up with your own. That's why I went and got an adjustable, and that should be good enough. Okay, so we're going to open this framework up. Okay. And we have a couple of connection bars, and what we're going to do is attach these, one on each side. Okay, so it does come with, what did I do with the other bag? Here it is. It comes with the bolts and nuts and everything that you need. The baggies are labeled as to which ones are which. These are the 40 millimeter. The other baggie that I have is the 30 millimeter. And so they are labeled so you know which ones to use with which items that you're attaching. So let me get these out. And we're going to attach okay. Now this is one of the 40 millimeters. It does have two washers, a nut, and the bolt, and what we're doing is we're attaching it to this framework up here. So we're going to put it through the holes, put the washer on, drop the nut. Okay. And then we're going to screw this on here. And using the two wrenches that they provide, we're going to be able to tighten this down. Maybe. Okay. Now, this is a lock nut, so that does help with this issue. Because once you get it on here, it will stay in place a lot better. So I've got one end attached now, okay. I may want to tighten that down a little bit more once I get the other end connected up. Now the other end of this, we're going to be using a T-bar connector because this way you'll be able to remove this, collapse it, and be able to store it easier. So they make it nice. They provide you with an easier way of, rather than using a wrench and everything every time, it just unscrews. And we're going to put this up here at this other... this other end. Okay, so what we're going to be doing, we're putting this bolt in here. There's a square hole here, and that's because this bolt, it's squared off on the inside there. So we're going to put it through, and we're going to line it up with the holes in the bar there, and pull it through. So it pops into that square, and then we'll be able to put our T-bar on here and tighten it down. Okay, now we're fastened up. We're ready to go on this side. Now I have to go and do the same thing on the other side. So we'll be back in just a few minutes after I get that accomplished. Okay, this framework over here, I just had to bend it back into place to be able to fit this bar in there. During shipment, it got kind of pinched together, so it was definitely too tight of a positioning to have been able to fit that in there. So when this arrived, the box was a little bit crushed. That was a shipping issue, and evidently that was the damage that transferred a little bit. It's not bad. I used the wrench here and just kind of placed it in there and wedged it just a little bit, and it bent right back into place. So we'll be back in a minute once I finish putting this together. Okay, so I've got my connecting rods on here now. Now we're going to be installing the axles. The axles slide into this area here, and using the 30 millimeter nuts and bolts, we are going to attach the axle to the bar underneath here. These also come with two washers, so you'll be able to put the washer at both sides. Okay, and they also have lock nuts, which I like. Now we're going to be using the other end of the wrenches provided. It's a smaller sized, fitting on the smaller ends of the nuts and bolts. So we just tighten these down. I do like that they provide most of the tools needed. You only have one tool that you have to supply yourself, and that's just because of the size of the bolt here for the nut that goes on this axle. As you can see, that's pretty good sized, and these definitely aren't going to fit. But they provide basically everything else that you need. So now I'm going to let's get this one installed real quick. Okay, so I've got both of my axles installed. So now we're ready to put on a wheel. So I'm going to go ahead and take this Okay, so I've taken the nut off of this axle. I'm thinking that it'll be easier to work off of that top one. It does have washers that you add on. Okay, you're supposed to put one washer on, then put your wheel on, put your other washer on, and then your nut. Okay. Oops. A little heavier than once you get the wheel on there. So let me go ahead and put this other wheel on this side, and that might make it a little easier for me to that one, washer, and okay, so now we're just going to crank this on here. This also is a lock nut, so okay, and I'm using an adjustable wrench. I figured that was the easiest way to do this. You could just, you know, use any kind of tool that you want to that's big enough for this. Okay. And you don't want to put it on there too tight, or you're not going to be able to, there we go, spin the wheel. I cranked it down a little too tight at first. So, you also don't want it too loose, because then you'll have too much wobble in your wheel here. But it is a lock nut, so it should stay in place fairly well through use. But anytime you want to take it out, you may want to check it just to make sure that your wheels are firmly in place, but where they are still movable. So let me get this other side tightened down, and we'll be right back to show you the rest of this. Okay, so here's our cart assembled, wheels on and everything. Now, there are a couple of straps here, and the cover. So, let me see if I can figure out how to install this. Okay. I'm looking at the diagram, trying to make sure that I know which way to do this. Okay, so the straps have these nice little snaps to them, and so we're just going to go around and get them to snap in place. Okay. So far, this has actually been fairly easy to assemble, which is nice. And it looks like the straps will just go around the ends once I get to them. Okay. And once I get all this on here, I'll show you how you can fold it down for storage. Because the way this all attaches, you really don't have to take it completely apart. to be able to fold it up and store it. And you can leave the cloth and everything on there. Okay, almost there. Yeah, this is where it's nice to have a second person to give a hand.
Those look really hard to snap.
Actually, they're not that bad. What I've been doing is I use the framework to snap them in place. But I was trying to snap on the wrong strap. Okay, so these are the straps. These are, you know, basically quick release for basically tying your cargo down. They do come with this strap not threaded through here, but they are adjustable, and you just thread it through, and then you'll be able to do the quick release. It's pretty nice. And what you can do is just tighten this down on here, and now you've got your strap. It's on here. You can even possibly unbuckle one of these and attach it. But this way it's on here, so when you get your deer, you put your deer on here, and then you'll be able to take this off of here, strap it around the deer, tighten it down, and you can just have it, you know, it's on here without being in the way and without without losing it. And you've got two of them. You can probably, you know, you could possibly do it at the other end. You could do it inside of the bars here, so it's closer inside the framework. You can put them pretty much anywhere that you want to, but I think I'm just going to put them on here like this. And just tighten it down. Okay. And there you go. Okay. Now, if you want to collapse this down for storage, what you're going to do is you're going to undo these. Try not to drop it. Tighten that back on there a little bit so that it stays in place so you don't lose it. Actually, I got it. There we go. Okay. And actually what it shows, what I had missed, there's a couple of little spots right here. What you do is you just take this bolt out, you put it in here, and tighten it down. And that'll hold that in place. But now you've got it for nice storage purposes. It's rather compact and it'll store nicely. Okay, so I'm attempting to sit in this and see what happens and see how well this works.
Look how easy that is.
Okay. Okay. And Sheri has moved me around a little bit. She said it was pretty easy to move me.
I couldn't even tell you to sit in it.
Okay.
But you better hop out before it flips.
I've got it.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm only about 165, 170 pounds or so. So that's not too bad. But it's fairly easy to move, you know, my weight. It does say not to exceed 550 pounds. So if by chance, you know, you get that 600 pound deer, you know, this isn't going to work real well for you. You're going to run a risk of damaging it. You know, if you, you know, go out elk hunting, this is probably not what you're going to want with you. But a 400 or 500 pound deer, this will work pretty well for. It was pretty easy to put together, pretty easy to collapse it down and store it, I think. And I kind of like it. It's a portable lounge chair.
I'm gonna use it for feed bags.
Sheri says she's gonna use it for feed bags, which that's not too bad of an idea either. Could also use it for moving bags of soil or compost. If you've got small livestock, you know, like goats, this might work okay for moving them as well. Although a live animal may not take too well to... But a sick animal, maybe you could get by with, you know, if it's not struggling too much, get it on here and move it. Possibly bales of hay also. But this is a fairly nice little cart, and I think we're gonna get some at least unusual uses out of it. So thank you and have a great day.